This is a horse, and this obviously art, and I'm standing next to someone that is quite related to art, which is Jose. Hello, Jose.
Hello.
Jose, we met when we were doing the tour right through Nevada, and we were stuck at this beautiful and uber-stylish vineyard that you might have seen, which is his. And Jose, please tell us, are you one of these people that is working with quite a lot of folks, or how many people are working at your vineyard?
We are only three people, so it's a full commitment. This is a life project. We are so much involved, and we have so much passion, and this is what we try to reflect in the style of the wines.
Yes. You might be surprised, but Jose already knows because we ordered from him. But one of the wines that we are featuring here at Caturistic is actually my favorite. He has quite a lot, but the ultra premium of premiums is the Tande Macula. I'm going to see if I can zoom on the logo right here. And the Macula is wonderful. Jose, some more things about the Macula.
Macula in Latin means fleck, stain. So what we... Why did we give this name to the wine? Because we believe that it could be a stain that can remain in one's brain, memory, once the wine has been drunk or enjoyed. And what is Macula? Macula is a blend of Cabernet Merlot. It's our top wine, although all of them are important.
Of course, they're all top. They have to be.
Yeah.
Yes,
and,
okay.
We at the winery, as you know, we apply a philosophy of minimal intervention. The less we do to the wines, the less we do to the grapes, the better. So we work very much by gravity.
Yes.
Putting the grapes in the winery from the upper part. We don't use pumps. We use cup planting like in the old times. In a sense, it's a paradox because we are said to be modern when we do things like they used to be done 50 or 60 years ago. Now we have technology. In the past, they had to do everything by hand. It was labor cost. So we ferment the stainless steel, and then once the alcohol fermentation is finished, and why we don't use pans? Because we want to get very, very fine, very elegant tannins. This is very important for us.
Yes.
No stress.
And what is really what amazed me when I saw it is that you can actually walk down from the vineyard, walk down, and you're right there in the cellars. You're going down, you can see the cement, then you're seeing the barrel-aged, the oaks, you have the barrels, and then all of a sudden you have the bottle, and it's right there. It's just in a walk by gravity. It's amazing.
Yeah. At the end, the building can be beautiful, you can be in a beautiful landscape, but the important thing for us is wine. So this is what matters. And the building is nice, it's elegant, it's there in the Camino de Santiago, with all the positive energy. I mean, it's not something flashy, it's elegant, which is important.
It looks like a Mies van der Rohe, but anyhow, it's all about the wine, we know. But you like the style as well, huh?
Exactly. But what matters is what is inside, what you do to wine, what you do to your grapes. So we ferment over there in the top, when the reception comes, the grapes, and we ferment the stainless steel, and then by gravity, run the wine to lower story to concrete.
Yes.
And we keep, I mean, it's difficult to think about this when you talk to someone, when you have such amount of wine in your cellar, but we keep all the wines in concrete for minimum 2 years settling down. And this is very unique. We didn't know about this before we started making the wines at Tandem.
That it would behave so well.
Yeah, we learned from experience.
Okay.
We understood that the wine could be stable, not doing anything. We don't fine the wines. Fining is using a fining agent and putting them on top of the wine, and the wine would, this fine agent will settle and would sweep things away. If you have patterns and you wait, this will be natural and all the complexity will be there. The wine will be stable, everything will be settled slowly with so much time, 3 years, 2-3 years, but the complexity will be preserved in the wine, and that's very important for us.
Wonderful. And now, one thing I have to jump in because everyone is not going to click away. We had this one white wine that you're producing. It's the Immacola. And we had it last year. We tried it at the vineyard and we said it's wonderful. So we asked you, we begged you actually to get the last set of bottles. You gave it to us. And then you called me and you said, the new wine I have is not, that was Viognier by then, and which was actually very, very good. And today you told me and you showed me that you have the Viura. But the Viura is totally different to what everyone would expect from a Viura wine. Yeah. It's not fresh and strong on acidity and running through your throat, but it's very, very gentle and very, very mature, I must say. Huh?
Mm. Now, Viura is quite an abandoned grape. It's not so fancy as Chardonnay or Sauvignon Blanc or even Viognier. So the first step we took last year before the harvest was to find beautiful grapes.
Yes.
And Alicia did it, and it was... They were beautiful, really small bunches, small grapes, beautiful smell, and we could feel it was going to be something special.
Mm-hmm.
So what we did, it's a fine, elegant grape. In the past, it used to be a fruity wine that suddenly, after 3-4 months, will oxidize and
yes.
It won't be so interesting anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And we tried to do something different, and we are sure we can do it. Well, sure so far. So 1/3 of the wine is fermented in French oak and 2/3 fermented in stainless steel. What we have in French oak, 300 liter barrels at the cellar, only 8, so it's very small production. It's later on kept in the oak for another 2 months, and every day slowly we steer the wine doing batonnage to gain volume.
Mm.
So the way we want in Magna and any of the wines we produce to be, is to be horizontal, to be elegant, to be intriguing, that the wines will talk to you and we keep selling things.
That looks wonderful. So, we know that, so we're going to stop it now, but thanks for telling us all these things about it, and of course, everyone, you know where you can order this wine, just have a look, and at your next function, your next catering, make sure to ask Cateristic for some very good Immacula from Jose. Thanks for having us
Thank
here.
You so much.
Okay, bye-bye. Ciao. And we'll take a look at some more art now. Okay, right. Bye.
You can do with the horse.